Front and back. Eagles along the side of the shorts. Ball in the air. Tapped once. Tapped again. And the Iona Gales will have it first. We are underway. At the point, here's Gist with it. Bounce pass, E.J. Crawford. Dribble handoff to Ricky McGill. Likewise, back to Gist. Motion offense here for the Gales. McGill with it. Throws it on the block. Backing down the defenders, Tawan Agee. His runner on the way, no good. Offensive rebound, McGill. Stick back is good. Ricky McGill with the offensive rebound. 2-0 Iona. Back comes Niagara. Here's Khalif Tate off the window. That one no good. Rebound battled for. Agee's got it, and he'll leave it for E.J. Crawford. Purple Eagles got that ball out of the hoop, and we're in the offensive zone in a hurry. Ricky McGill with it now. Enters the pass to E.J. Crawford. Size mismatch there. He's backing down James Towns. Couple of dribbles. Kicks it back out. Agee's going to hoist a deep three, and that is good. Tawan Agee, who's had three double-doubles in his last 10 ball games, makes it a 5-0 Iona score. Niagara, who has lost three in a row overall, you know they want a fast start to this one. There's an entry pass to Dominic Robb. He'll spin at the free throw line. Jumper on the way. That one no good. One and done. Rebound Crawford. Outlet McGill. Here he comes right in front of us. Ricky McGill flips it back to Crawford. Fakes the three. Now loops the pass to Perez. Ben Perez all the way to bucket. Finger roll. No good. That one missed. Rebound James Towns. Towns into the front court. Backs the pass to Marvin Prochet, but stolen away by Perez. Perez to Crawford. Into the front court come the Gales. Crawford back to Perez. His three on the way. That one hit the backboard first, and it's picked up by Marvin Prochet. Back and forth we go. A ton of possessions already, 90 seconds in. Interior pass. Dominic Robb, reverse layup, no. Gets his own rebound and sticks it back up and in. Dominic Robb has the Purple Eagles in flight. Niagara trailing it now 5-2. Asante Gist into the front court. Tugs on his jersey, new play call. That must mean he wants Agee to come out and set the screen, but he fires the pass the other way. Agee's got it now. Chest pass right wing. Here's Gist. Hesitation move. Now throws it in the paint. Spinning on Dom is Agee. Rattles in and out. Boy, from in tight there. The rim betrays Agee. Rebound Prochet. Back he comes. Left wing pass. Towns. James, a three for the tie. That one no good. Rebound battled for and knocked out of bounds. Last touch by Perez. And I'll tell you what, that young man with a headlong dive did all he could to save it. It's a good thing those cushy chairs to our right only go so far. He might have gone headlong into the seat. So Niagara with a fresh shot clock, trailing at 5-2. Prochet on the catch. He's going to hoist a deep three. That one in and out, no good. Rebound by Agee. He'll flip it to Gist. Back comes Gist into the front court, trying to shake free of Leaf, but he can't do it. So now the pass comes to E.J. Crawford. E.J. spinning on James Towns, backing him down in the paint, kicks it to McGill. McGill, looping pass now to Crawford, again backing down James Towns. Jump stop through the paint, now to Gist, kick an extra pass in the corner. Perez three, that one no good. Perez has missed his first three shots. Here comes Towns back for Niagara. James in the corner, now touch pass up top, Prochet, backing down Gist. Ball fake, shot in the way, good. Marvin Prochet, an 8-foot jumper from the baseline. Shooting over the shorter player. Back comes McGill. His shot no good. It rimmed out. Rebound Prochet. Niagara looks for their first lead of the ballgame. 16:50 left, first half. Tate with it now. Gist out to get him. Great move by Khalif. All the way to the bucket. Runner on the way. No good. Offensive rebound, Dominic Robb. Kicks it to Towns. Now to Prochet. Top of the key. Three. Good. Back-to-back buckets by Marvin Prochet. He pounds his chest and he gives Niagara the 7-5 lead. 7-0 run by the Purple Eagles. Gist with the basketball. Runs Towns into a screen, flips it back. E.J. Crawford a deep three. That one on the way, and that one is swished through. Well, Prochet gave him a step, thinking perhaps that was outside of E.J.'s range, and that swish will change that thinking. Towns with it now. Iona back in front, 8-7. James all the way to the bucket. To the defender he goes. Layup good. James Towns able to take on the shot block attempt there of Agee. Here's McGill into the front court. Back to Agee. Right back to McGill. They play catch. Ricky McGill from the free throw line. Jumper on the way. That is good. Well, both teams now starting to find their stride already. Our fourth lead change in the first 4+ minutes. Media timeout at the next whistle. We got 10 players on the floor just gasping for air. Towns, right wing pass Prochet. Kick at the corner, Leaf. He'll step in, a two-pointer on the way. That one is good. Khalif Tate is the fourth different Purple Eagle to score. Niagara back in front, 11-10. Gist with it. Enters the pass to McGill. He'll rise up, fires it over Towns, and that one is good. How about this start? 15-15 left, 12-11 Iona. Towns with it now, jogs over the center court stripe. Crochet now to Barton. Barton hasn't touched the ball much, and he'll give it to Towns. Here's James again. Off the screen set by Dominic Rupp. Keeps the dribble alive. Now will throw it to Dom along the baseline. Hasn't dribbled yet. One quick dribble. Double team comes, and a reach-in foul on the Gales. That will be our first foul of the ball game, and it's on Asante Gist. His first, 14:53 left. Media timeout. We will step aside. And welcome back to Purple Eagles basketball. Niagara ready to inbound, trailing it 12-11. Well, good shooting here to open this game. Each team 5 for 11. Iona's 2 for 4 from deep. Niagara 1 for 3. Khalif Tate to inbound. Throws it high up top to Dominic Robb. Has a contested there from McGill, and Ricky McGill steals it. Bounce pass, Gist, fadeaway 3 in the corner. That one no good. And the weak side rebound by Khalif Tate, who just got into the backcourt to pick up that loose ball. James Towns with it now in the corner to Marv. Iona recovers defensively. Marv all the way to the bucket, gives it to Barton. Layup is good. Count the basket and the foul. Chris Barton on just his second touch of the opening half gives Niagara the lead 13-12, and he'll go to the line. That ball got knocked out of the hands of Marvin Prochet. I didn't see whose face it went off of, but if I look closely, maybe we could see an Iona player wincing. It went into the hands of Chris Barton. He drew the foul on E.J. Crawford and laid it in. Free throw is no good. It rimmed out. Niagara retains that one-point lead, 13-12. Here's Gist with it into the front court. On the left-hand bounce, hesitation move, now along the baseline. Feeds the pass to Agee. Tried to dunk it. He missed, but a foul on Niagara's Dominic Robb. Well, that is the first on Dom and the first on Niagara as a team. So Tawan Agee will go to the line. He hit 68% of his free throws this year. 38 for 56. First one is on the way, and it is swished in there. 4 points for the Chicago, Illinois native. Three quick dribbles, now the deep knee bend. The release, and that one is good. He knew it all along. 14-13, Iona out in front. First look we'll have it, a full court trap by the Gales. Little 1-2-2 look. Inbounds pass to James Towns. Flips it to Marv. Marv over the timeline now to Barton. Chris avoids a double team, whips it across the floor to Dominic Robb. Dom back to Towns. 15 to shoot. Barton with it, between the legs, on Perez. A little wiggle. Ball fake at the free throw line. Runner on the way. That one no good. Barton goes after the rebound, but Perez able to get it now to Agee. Agee releases it to Gist. Here come the Gales into the front court. A deep three on the way by Asante. That one no good. All Purple Eagles underneath, and Prochet with a rebound. Now to Towns. James Towns. Bounce pass right wing to Marv. He's going to hoist a three. That one is off the iron. No good. And the rebound to Gist. Iona looking to run. In the front court, Perez layup. That one is good. Now, Ben Perez could feel the presence of Marvin Prochet, but he was able to get that one to drop through. Greg King and Raheem Solomon at the scorer's table for Niagara. Entry pass to Dominic Robb. Bangs into Agee. Kicks it to Towns. James was open for the three. Faked it. Now release the pass to Khalif. He'll hoist a three. That one on the way. That one is no good. Rebound Agee. Outlet Gist. 2-on-2. Here's Gist. A little step through, and he lays it in. Asante Gist gets his first field goal. Iona has equaled their largest lead at 5. They led the game 5-0 before Niagara got on the stat sheet. Here's Leaf with it. Right elbow jumper. That one on the way. No good. Gets his own rebound. Fresh clock for the Purple Eagles. Whip pass up top. Barton along 3. Off the front rim. No good. Tap to Prochet for Niagara. Marv goes up off glass. That one missed. And this time the rebound to Agee. Agee to McGill. Here's Ricky McGill in the front court. He'll pull up a high-arcing three off the iron. No good. Rebound Dominic Robb. For the Gales, they fire up that shot so quickly, they have no offensive rebound threat. Towns with it now. Towns to Dominic Robb. Whips a pass left wing to Prochet. Here's Marv against Gist. Puts it on the deck, and a traveling violation is called against Marvin Prochet. Bill McCarthy with the call. Marv was right next to Ron Taberski, so he asked him what he thought about it. And of course, the officials backing up one another as they say Marv dragged the pivot foot. Substitutions for the Purple Eagles. Marcus Hammond will also join Raheem Solomon and Greg King, who check in. James Towns, Chris Barton, and Dominic Robb to the sideline. On the other side, Iona has brought in their first sub, the Robert Morris transfer. That's Isaiah Still, the junior from Rahway, New Jersey. Fires the pass to McGill. McGill now to E.J. Crawford. Now to A.G. A.G.'s going to step back, a long two on the way, and that one is good. So on A.G. now is seven, and that is the lead for Iona, 20-13. Hammond to Prochet. Marv looks to his right, finds Solomon. Raheem Solomon looking at a 2-3 zone defense for Iona. Here's Khalif Tate. Went behind the back, stolen away by Ricky McGill. Ricky looking to run. Layup is good. 8 points for Ricky McGill, and the Purple Eagles call timeout. With 11:43 left, this will be our media timeout. We were download the TickPick app on Apple or Android devices and save. That's TickPick, every ticket, no hidden fees. Nick Lozanowski is back in our Amherst studios. John Cacciatore to my right on stats. My name is Todd Callen. A 9-0 run by Iona has given them a 10-0 run. Made it 22-13. Greg King will slam that one through as Niagara breaks the press. King with a little rim rattler to our right, and that'll snap that 10-0 run. 22-15. Gist to Still fires a chest pass to E.J. Crawford. Now to A.G. A.G. back to McGill. Trying to shake free of Hammond. Kicks in the corner. A whistle, and that should be an offensive foul, and it is. Ricky McGill released the pass, and he tried to put the brakes on. He just couldn't, and he didn't steamroll into Khalif. He just kind of nudged him. But Khalif was there, and he draws the charge. 22-15 the score. Marcus Hammond, the freshman, brings the ball up the court. Hammond from Queens to Solomon, now to Khalif Tate. Here's Leaf, left wing, right in front of Tim Kluge. Fires the pass to Prochet. Enters it now to Greg King, going to work on A.G. Then it gets stolen away by Ricky McGill. He'll fire it to Crawford. Here's E.J. Crawford all the way to the bucket. He lays it in. He's got five. Well, we mentioned Iona, very adept at stealing the basketball, and they got a theft right there. Prochet with it now to Solomon. 10:43 left first half. Here's King from the free throw line. That one no good. He left it short. That one saved by a pair of Purple Eagles, but right to Ricky McGill. And Iona looking to run. Gist layup blocked away by Greg King to Prochet. Back comes Niagara. Whip pass in the corner. Leaf open, a three on the way. That one is good. You talk about a quick release. Khalif's got five. Back comes Gist. 24-18 the score. Here's E.J. Crawford with it. In the first 10 minutes, that has had a ton of possessions. These two teams, kind of a mirror image. They love to get up and go. Here's E.J. Crawford with it. Backing down Solomon, the junior, on the left-hand bounce. Picks up the dribble. Throws it to A.G. in the paint. He's been in there a long time, and he lays it in. Boy, dangerously close to a three-second violation. 26-18, Iona by eight. Marcus Hammond now, who's played very well over the last half dozen games. Bounce pass right wing, Solomon. He's left alone. His three on the way is perfect. Raheem Solomon, who looks like he could play for 40 minutes and not break a sweat. The coolest guy in the building. Niagara down by five, 26-21. E.J. Crawford to McGill. He'll flip the ball to Gist. There's Gist now, picked up by Tate. Little bounce now to A.G. Again, backing down Greg King. Fade away from the baseline. Off the window and good. What a first half for A.G. He's got 11. He averages just over 12 a game. Khalif with it. Fires it up top to Hammond. Right back to Leaf. Leaf throw it in the baseline. Here's King with it. Greg King now backing down A.G. Extra dribble in the paint. Kicks it back to Leaf. An open three from the top. That one is good. He's a streaky shooter, and he's on a hot streak, folks. Niagara down by four. Leaf has eight. That leads away for the Purple Eagles. 8:45 left. Yes, now to E.J. Crawford. Fakes a three. Now in the corner. Still, ball fake. Bangs into Leaf, and we have a whistle. And I think we've got an offensive foul, and we do. Offensive foul on Isaiah Still. That is his first. Fourth team foul in the Gales. Checking in for Iona is Jonathan Maxwell. As Tawan Agee will get his first rest. Perez back on the floor, and now Asante Gist will get a towel for his first time on the sideline. 8.5 minutes left, first half. Here's Hammond, little runner in the paint. That one no good. Rebound battled for, and Maxwell picks it up for the maroon and gold outlet to Ricky McGill. Here's McGill, fires it in the corner. Perez fakes a three, leap out to get him. Skip pass across the floor, caught by Crawford. E.J. Crawford now to McGill. Ball fake on the pass. Now McGill in the paint, little runner. Nope, he kicks the pass right wing. Extra touch pass. Maxwell a deep three. That one no good. Missed that one by plenty. Rebound King, outlet Prochet. Four on three for Niagara if they hurry. Leaf Tate, his shot on the way. That one is no good. The rebound of Perez, he saves it. No, he didn't. It goes out of bounds. Last touch by Perez. And that was a break because Khalif Tate would have had an easy layup. Timeout with 7:55 left in the first. Basketball, it'll be Niagara to inbound in the front court after Perez knocked it out of bounds. Dominic Fergala on the floor for the Purple Eagles, coming off a career high 20 points in defeat on Monday night at Fairfield. He was a bright spot. Fergala now to Raheem Solomon. Raheem backs things out. Now to Fergala. Whip it across the floor to a true freshman, Marcus Hammond. Hammond, crossover dribble, jump pass, back to Solomon. His three on the way. That one is good. Right in front of the Iona bench, Raheem Solomon hits Niagara's fifth three of the opening half, and the Purple Eagles are down by one, 28-27. Niagara 5-for-10 from three. Here's Still with it to the bucket. Nope, he'll fire it to E.J. Crawford. Good catch, or else that would have hit the Niagara bench. McGill, ball fake, now to Still. Still up and under move on King, no good, but a foul will send Isaiah Still to the line to shoot two. For Greg King, that is his first. Last time we were this close, it was 14-13, Iona. Now Still will go to the line to shoot two, 62% on the season. Missed the last couple of ball games with an injury, but he's back and ready to go here tonight. Free throw is no good. In and out. Tawan Agee back in, and E.J. Crawford will sit for the first time. Andrea Rastanovich not able to go here tonight for the Gales. Second free throw. That one is no good. Rebound tapped up, and an over-the-back foul on Agee. That'll be his first 15 foul. So no Rastanovich. He's got his right foot in a boot. So if you look over to the Iona bench, there are five players that are in uniform. And there are six gentlemen in suits. So the suits have the players outnumbered on the Iona bench here right now. There's Marcus Hammond with it now to Fergala. Dom enters the pass now to Dominic Robb, and he traveled. Oh, Dom knew it. Trying to shake free there of Maxwell. Agee's going to come back in, and Gist will go right back out. With 6:58 left in the first half, I don't think that was an offense for defense switch yet, but Gist wasn't in there long. Here's Ricky McGill now looking at a 2-3 Niagara zone defense. Hammond and Fergala up top. Dominic Robb in the center on the baseline, flanked by Solomon on his left and Marvin Prochet on his right. Still now to Ricky McGill. Throw it to Agee. Back and down Dominic Robb. Bangs into him. Bounce pass knocked away by Solomon, but right to Still. Now to Agee. Whip pass in the paint. That one knocked away. It's loose. Saved by Perez and stolen away by Prochet. Niagara looking to regain the lead. They're in the front court. Down by one. Solomon a high arcing three, and that one is good. Triple, triple, triple for Raheem Solomon, and Niagara back in front 30-28. 6:12 left. Perez and McGill play catch. Now to Agee. Agee, little wiggle. His shot blocked away by the leader in the MAC. Dominic Robb's got another one. To Marcus Hammond to the bucket, and that gets swiped away by Ricky McGill. Now to Still. Still back the other way. Layup is good. Great defense at both ends in a 30-30 game. Inside of 6 minutes, just our first tie of this wild first half. James Towns and Greg Quackamentz at the scorer's table for Niagara. They'll check in at the next whistle. Here's Raheem Solomon to the bucket. Layup, yes, and the foul. Raheem Solomon, what a first half for the freshman. count the bucket. The foul is on Tawan Agee, and that's his second. 16 foul on Iona, and with 5:38 left, Raheem Solomon will go for the old-fashioned three-point play. Now hold on a minute, because Tawan Agee said something to Ron Taberski, questioning that the foul was on him. And in fact, Ron Taberski, the referee, is going to go over to the monitor. And I guess this is our first fact check of the night. What are you listening to my teammate for? 32-30, Niagara with the lead. Raheem Solomon to the line. 77% for Solomon. Free throw on the way. That is perfect. He's hit the rim once. Three swished threes and then a layup and a free throw. Niagara leading it 33-30. Largest lead of the night for the Purple Eagles. Right wing, Perez has it now to Gist. Desante Gist is still. Thought about a three. Kwakumenza got out on him quickly. Now Agee, a deep three on the way from the wing. That one no good. Rebound, James Towns. Niagara looking to run. Towns, right wing. Solomon, his three on the way. Off the back iron, no good. Rebound, battled for. Tap by Maxwell to Agee, and now Iona will come back. Right to left, go the Gales. Gist flips it to Agee. Extra pass goes through the legs of Isaiah Still. Agee beat him five hole. Fourth turnover the opening half on Iona. 5:01 left. Our LCTV audience gets a good look there at Greg Kwakumenza to inbound the basketball. The sophomore from Worcester, Mass. There's James Towns with it now. Towns, Kwakumenza, Fragala, Solomon, and Dominic Robb. Now James will balance the floor against his 2-3 Iona's own defense. Bounce pass Fragala. Bounce pass in the corner to Solomon. Jump stop. Picks up the dribble now to Towns. James thought about a three. Didn't release. Shot clock at 8. James Towns into the paint he goes. Little floater from the free throw line. No good. Tapped out by Dominic Robb to Maxwell as the Iona Gales. Big man able to steal that one away. He'll give it now to Still. Niagara 33, Iona 30. Crawford back to Gist. You wonder if they'll get E.J. Crawford a good look here. Shot clock at 12. Gist, he's going to hoist a deep three. That one rattles in. Asante Gist now with 5, and we are tied at 33. Second tie. James Towns with it now. 4 minutes left in the opening half. Towns, throw it on the block. Here's Dominic Robb. Rises up, off glass, good, and the foul. What a feed to free up Dominic Robb. The layup, he will shoot a free throw when we come back. Niagara 35, Iona 33. 3:58 left from Van Wagner. This is the Purple Eagles. Dominic Tioli doing the honors here this evening. Niagara 14 of 31. Iona 14 of 27 from the floor. The difference, Niagara 6 for 12 from deep. Iona 3 for 10. Dominic Robb's free throw is on the way, and that one is good. Dom finishes the old-fashioned three-point play for his fifth point. Rebounding story, Niagara out-rebounding the Gales 18 to 14. Purple Eagles, 9 assists on 14 baskets. They've turned it over 7 times. Iona, 6 assists on 14 baskets. They've turned it over 4 times. Here's Asante Gist with it. 10 to shoot, Still with it. Puts it on the deck, spins away from the defender now to Gist. Gist bangs into Dominic Fragala, and a blocking foul, I believe, is going to be called on Niagara's redshirt freshman, Fragala. That is his first. 3:34 left, just a third team foul. They'll reset the shot clock to 20. Thus the thumbs up from Ron Taberski. Isaiah Still to inbound. 3:34 left. Niagara leading it by 3. 36-33. Iona's 2-0. Niagara 0-2. Inbounds play to E.J. Crawford. It's Solomon on him. He's going to take him to the baseline. Layup on the way. That one no good. Rebound Kwakumenza. Flip it to James Towns. James has to be careful. A couple of Gales lurking. James, crossover dribble, kicks it to Raheem. Another three on the way. That one off the iron, no good. Rebound tap to E.J. Crawford, and a blocking foul on Raheem Solomon as he cut into his path. So for Raheem, that is his first. After a white-hot start from the floor by Solomon, he's missed his last couple of three-pointers. Niagara with the lead by 3, 36-33. Ricky McGill on the sideline for Iona with 2 first-half fouls. It's a chance potentially for Niagara get a little distance here. Perez nearly fumbled that one away. Now to Still, inside of 3 minutes. Still, back pass to Gist. Here's Gist, trying to shake free of Towns, can't do it. Flips the pass to Still, around the defender, Kwakumentsa. Ball fake shot, blocked away, and then prior to the release, a foul is called on Greg Kwakumentsa. Oh, the paying customers disagree with Bill McCarthy there. And two free throws upcoming for Isaiah Still. Still 0 for 2 in the ball game from the line. So we'll see. See if the ball don't lie. Free throw on the way. That one is good. Third point of the day. Last season with the Colonials of Robert Morris, Isaiah Still averaged nearly 16 points. And I say last season, that would, of course, be 2 seasons ago. Still had to sit out due to NCAA transfer regulations last year. Trying to bring Iona to within one. Free throw on the way. That one is too strong. It rattled out. Rebound Dominic Robb. To Towns. Here's James Towns. Crossover dribble. Boy, he is quick as a hiccup. Now to Fergala. Dominic Fergala. He's going to pull up. His three on the way. That one is good. A high arcing rainbow three by Dominic Fergala. Talking to Dom on the road trip, he said if he hits his first one, boy, he feels awfully good. He struggled at the beginning of the year, but 20 last game at Fairfield, and he buries that triple to give Niagara their largest lead at 5. AG with it now. Looking in the paint to Crawford. Lob pass caught by Crawford. Knocked away by Fergala. It'll be Iona ball with 10 on the shot clock. Well, Khalif Tate and Marvin Prochet have been on the sideline for a while here for the Purple Eagles, but whatever five are out there, and right now it's Kwakumentsa, Robb, Towns, Solomon, and Fergala. A lot of reserves playing good minutes here. Still better hurry. Inbounds play to AG. 8 to shoot. AG takes along the lane. Shot on the way. That one no good. Rebound tapped up. It missed. Loose ball picked up by Dominic Robb. Yes, he's got it. Outlet to Towns. 2 minutes left in the first half. Niagara by 5. James a 3 on the way. That one off the backboard first. No good. Rebound Dominic Robb. Floater. Yes. A little line drive there by Dominic Robb. He's got 7. Niagara's lead is 7. Here's Gist with it now. 41-34. Pass nearly stolen by Kwakumentsa. Gist picks it up. Looks at the shot clock. 18 on it. 100 seconds left in the first half. Gist to the bucket. Up and under move. That one no good. Saved by Fergala on the rebound. Outlet Solomon. Raheem Solomon right along the boundary. To the bucket. Layup. Yes! Great body control there by Raheem Solomon. And Coach Tim Kloos calls timeout. The Purple Eagles lead it by 9. 43-30 points, 22 apiece, but a good game inside the McCann Center. Timeout concluded. Ricky McGill back on the floor for Iona. Well, it's not a mystery when Ricky McGill is not on the floor. It does make things a little bit tougher offensively for this high-scoring Iona club. That's why that second foul was so key. He'll flip the pass to Gist. His three on the way. Off the iron, no good, and a long arcing rebound to Raheem Solomon. Niagara's lead is 9, 43-34. 65 seconds left. Right wing to Fergala. Oh, a double team comes, so he fires the pass to James Towns. Niagara with some accomplished perimeter shooters on the floor right now and a presence in the paint in Dominic Robb. Solomon throws it into the paint. Robb, layup on the way. That one no good. Rebound to Kwakumentsa. Ball fake, got the defender in the air. Off glass, no. Solomon the follow. That missed. But contact in the paint, and I believe Raheem Solomon will go to the line and shoot free throws. The foul will go on Asante Gist. That's a second on Gist, and now what do we have? I don't know if this is a warning being issued by Bill McCarthy or if, in fact, he assessed technical fouls to E.J. Crawford and Greg Kwakumentsa. Now McCarthy will go over to the official scorer, and I think that that's going to be the announcement. We won't get ahead of it, at least not for a second time. Well, up off the bench for Iona is Niksa Nikolic. And here comes Bill McCarthy. We appreciate this.
Double technical, 15 white, 2 red. They offset. We go back to
thank you, and that is the update. We did have that for you. Greg Kwakumentsa and E.J. Crawford assessed technical fouls. So for Crawford, that is his second. For Kwakamensa, that is his second. Those two fouls offset. So back to our regularly scheduled free throws for Raheem Solomon. It's on the way, and it is good. He'll have another. I'm running out of room on my score sheet for Raheem Solomon's first half. How about 15 points in the opening 20? Incredible. Solomon will have another, and I'll tell you what, Niagara will take that trade all day. Kwakamensa's second and E.J. Crawford's second. Free throw is good by Raheem Solomon. And he just now sets a new career high. 16 points for the Hartford, Connecticut native. Backdoor cut, Gist layup blocked away by Kwakamensa, but a whistle. Contact on the body. Gist went down hard, but he is solidly built. He popped right back up. The foul on Kwakamensa is his third. So with 38.2 seconds left, and Niagara leading it by 11, Marvin Prochet will go to the scorer's table. But he'll have to wait. There is Asante Gist at 5'11", 185 pounds. He will shoot two. A couple of dribbles is all he needs. Free throw on the way, and that one is good. Boy, it barely got there, but that perfect rotation got it over the rim and through. Kwakamensa will come out, but he'll get a nice ovation. So Prochet on the low block for the Purple Eagles. Across from him, Dominic Robb. Second free throw, that one around and out, no good. Rebound Robb. He'll leave it to Jamestown. 7 second differential between shot clock and game clock. Niagara's lead is 10, 45 to 35. Here's Towns with it. 14 on the shot clock. James across the floor to Fergala. Chest pass right back to Towns. Shot clock at 8. James now, he's going to step back, a long three on the way. That one off the rim, no good. Tapped up by Solomon, loose on the floor, and then gathered up by the Gales. Here's Isaiah Still. His pass to Perez, 5 seconds left. Ball fake, he's going to hoist the three. It's on the way, and it's good. Ben Perez with a big three that beat the buzzer. He's got 5 first half points. The Gales, McGill, Crawford, Gist, Perez, I think, although he's getting some last minute instruction, and also he's got now his left wrist and left thumb taped up. And Tawan Agee, second half underway. Right in front of us, Niagara will go right to left. 1-3-1 zone defense now. First look at that for the Gales. Niagara saw this a bunch against Fairfield. I don't think they handled it great. We'll see how they do tonight. Leaf with it. Throws to Dominic Robb. Right elbow, one dribble. Looping pass back to Leaf. Shot clock at 13. Here's Jamestown. Crossover dribble on Perez. Into the defender. Shot on the way. Blocked away. James has got it again. Tries to dribble out of trouble, but then it's stolen by McGill to Agee. There's Tawan Agee. You can bet that Iona is looking for a good first few minutes in this second half. Boy, mismatch down low. Towns was trying to tangle with Tawan Agee. Now E.J. Crawford's got it. Spinning in the paint away from James Towns. Up and under layup. No good. Gets his own rebound and sticks it up and in. E.J. Crawford with 7, and just like that, it's a 5-point Niagara lead. 45-40. Prochet right wing to Barton. Now to Khalif. Khalif will ask Dominic Robb to set the screen. Doesn't use it. Goes to the right side. Now we'll back out the dribble. Chest pass to James Towns. 13 to shoot. Minute gone in the second half. Dominic Robb with it. Backing down the defender. Left hand leaner. Good. Dominic Robb now with 9. Big bucket there as he took on Agee in the paint. Down bested him. 47-40. Niagara leads it. Here is Ricky McGill. A little jump in his step, turns the corner all the way to the bucket. Finger roll is good. That was too easy. I think Ricky lulled the Purple Eagles defenders to sleep and then kicked it into another gear and had an easy lay-in. 5-point lead again for the Purple Eagles. Niagara 0-2, Iona 2-0. Tate with it. Khalif, bounce pass. Right wing, Towns, throw it on the baseline to Barton. He'll hoist a three. That one is no good. Offensive rebound, Dominic Robb. Kicks it to James, fakes the three. Now to Tate, extra pass, corner three, Marv, yes! Marvin Prochet from his corner office. The Purple Eagles lead it by 8. 50-42. McGill. Little wiggle now, go left wing. Lob pass down low, Agee will dunk it through. A great no-look pass there by Ricky McGill to Tawan Agee, and that was easy. Niagara by 6, 50-44. That was a great no-look pass. Again, against a 1-3-1 defense. Khalif Tate, bounce pass Towns. James going to step into the paint. Skip it to Leaf. A wide open three. That one off the rim, no good. Rebound Gist. Leaf had a good look, but misfired. Here comes McGill into the front court. Flips the pass back to Gist. He'll hoist a three. That one is no good. Saved by Perez, but then he throws it out of bounds. Well, Ben Perez is all over the sidelines. If the ball is nearly going out of bounds, Perez will get it. Third time tonight that he's done that. Each time it's gone over to Niagara, but you have to admire the young man's hustle. Tate now to Towns. Towns back to Tate. Bounce pass in the corner to Prochet, knocked out of bounds. Last touch by the Gale, so with 19 to shoot, Niagara will inbound. Still looking for her first foul of the second half. There's an inbounds pass. That was too cavalier. It's stolen by Perez. Here's Perez, runner on the way. That one no good. Rebound, Dominic Robb. He'll leave it for Tate. Khalif Tate now. Around Crawford. Going to take to the bucket? No. Give it to Towns. Here's an open three. That one on the way. No good. Rebound, Dominic Robb. He's got 10 rebounds now. Gets a pass from Tate. 12-footer. Good by Dominic Robb. It's a double-double for Dominic Robb. 11 points, 10 rebounds to the minute. Perez, his pass knocked away by Dom, stolen by Leaf. Niagara by 8 with the possession. Leaf to Prochet, his 3. Good! Timeout, Iona. Marvin Prochet has 11. The lead is...
Blue Ox Roofing, a longtime sponsor of NU Athletics. Blue Ox Roofing has been the premier roofing company in the greater Buffalo Niagara region for over 30 years.
Well, Niagara trying to raise the roof here tonight. Boy, second half shooting by the Purple Eagles. Good start to the second half, outscoring Iona 10-6. Niagara 50% in the second half. So is Iona. They're 3-for-6, but Niagara has 2 3-point buckets. Here's E.J. Crawford with it. Crawford now picked up by Prochet along the left side of the lane. Shot on the way, no good. Gets his own rebound and puts it back up and in. Well, the M.O. here for the Gales might be trying it. E.J. Crawford rolling. He's got 9 points. Pass to Tate along the baseline. Almost hoisted a 12-footer, but McGill is right there. Pass back to Barton. He's going to hoist a three. It's on the way, and it's good! Chris Barton snuck that one in the side door. He's got 5. Niagara has their largest lead of the night. It's a dozen. 58-46. Nikolic checked in at the last whistle. E.J. Crawford now picked up by Barton. Boy, nearly traveled. Crawford back past A.G. Thought about a three. Dom was lurking. Pass in the paint, loose on the ground. Prochet goes to pick it up, and he'll flip it to James Towns. He ripped it away from Nikolic. Back comes Towns. Bounce pass to Dominic Robb. Floater on the way, around the rim and out, no good. And the foul on Dominic Robb, and he knew it. Boy, that ball just danced along the rim, and then in frustration, Dom fouled E.J. Crawford. That's his second on Dom. And that is the first foul of this second half. 15:33 left. Here is our under 16-minute media timeout. We'll step aside as well. Purple Eagles lead it by 12 from Van Wyck. Are we ready? Welcome back to Purple Eagles basketball as E.J. Crawford talks things over with Bill McCarthy on the baseline. 58-46, the score. Niagara leads it by 12. They roll the ball into Asante Gist. Here he comes into the front court. Flips it to Ricky McGill. McGill runs Leaf into a screen. Leaping catch there by Crawford, and underneath him was Chris Barton. He didn't give EJ any place to land, so that's the first on Barton. Second team foul on Niagara. So Iona to inbound. The shot clock had only got to 23, so no reset. They'll take advantage of the extra second, so 23 on the clock. Inbound to Gist. Gets to Agee. He's going to hoist a three over Prochet, and that one is good. Tawan Agee got the game started with the three, and now he hits another one. And it's a 9-point Niagara lead with a ton of time. Iona came back from a double-digit second-half deficit against Fairfield, so they know they can do it. Khalif with it. Bounce pass to Marv. Marv, jump stop in the paint, up and over the defender, off glass too strong, and the rebound to E.J. Crawford, outlet to McGill. Three on three. Here's Ricky McGill. Takes Towns in the paint. Floater. Swish. McGill with a dozen. And here come the Gales. A quick little 5-0 run. 58-51. Raheem Solomon and Greg King at the scorer's table for Niagara. Tate and Towns play catch. Towns has it. Back to Tate. He's going to hoist a three. It is off the rim. No good. Offensive rebound. Prochet put back. No, but a foul. That should be a shove in the back by Ricky McGill, and it is. So that's 3 on McGill. Marvin Prochet will go to the line. And you know Marv wanted to take that hit and still get the layup to go. Couldn't believe it didn't go down. First team foul of the second half on Iona. So Marv will shoot two. First trip to the line tonight for the senior. Free throw on the way. Good. Had to wait, but then it dropped through. A dozen points for Prochet. Dominic Robb and Khalif Tate come out with Raheem Solomon and Greg King checking in. Sometimes you'll see Chris Barton come out, but Barton probably the best on-the-ball defender for the Purple Eagles. Second free throw. That one off the back iron. No good. Rebound Agee. Agee outlet to McGill. McGill on the floor with four fouls. Now to Nikolic. His layup, good. Nixon Nikolic, the only Gale on that end of the floor, but he beat everybody to the rack. And it's a six-point Niagara lead, 59-53. 2-3 zone defense by the Gales. Here's Prochet, back to Solomon. Raheem Solomon's going to step back. His three partially deflected. That was Agee who got a hand on it. McGill comes back the other way for Iona. McGill to Agee, backing down Solomon. Double team comes, a whistle, and what do we have? A blocking foul on Raheem Solomon. Third team foul on the Purple Eagles for Raheem. That is his second. Our LCTV audience will get a look at this. It looked to me like Agee hooked him and then spun around. I think they missed that one. Asante Gist with it now. Agee got away with one. E.J. Crawford now left wing. He'll hoist a three. That one too strong off the iron. Saved by King to Prochet. Niagara looking to get out and go. Towns with it now. James Towns picked up by Agee. He's going to hoist a three. It's on the way, and it's off the back iron. No good. Rebound tapped by Nikolic to Agee, and back come the Gales. McGill with it. McGill runs Towns into a screen. He's going to pull up. Left elbow jumper. That one is good. Ricky McGill is feeling it, folks. He's got 14. Marcus Hammond up off the bench for Niagara, and Iona to within four. That's off the crest of a 10-4 run by the Gales here. 13-13 left. Towns thought about a deep three. Didn't release. Instead, will go to Prochet. Prochet on the baseline to Greg King. Right back to Marvin. It's knocked away and stolen by McGill. Here comes Iona. Pass to Crawford. EJ layup. Good. Timeout, Niagara. EJ Crawford with 11, and it's a two-point game. With 13-0 long ago, was it a dozen points, 58-46. So 11-1 run by Iona. Here's Marcus Hammond with it. 6'1" freshman. Hammond on the right-hand bounce. Fires it to Solomon. Raheem Solomon skips it to Marv. He's got an open three. That one is good. A big bucket out of the timeout by Marvin Prochet. 4 3-pointers. This season, Marv shooting at a career-high percentage from deep. Ricky McGill, lob pass, Nikolic, layup, no good, he missed it. Rebound King, outlet Hammond. Niagara by five with the possession. Marcus Hammond slams on the brakes, fires it to Prochet. Here's Marv with E.J. Crawford out to get him. He'll release the pass to Hammond. 2-3 zone defense. Well, they will match up. Hammond with it now, 13 to shoot. Back pass, Barton fakes the three. To the free throw line. Cut off there by Nikolic, who'll give a wraparound pass now to Prochet. Shot clock at three. Here's Marv. Fadeaway jumper. No good. Rebound Agee. And a foul on the Purple Eagles on the rebound. It'll be on Chris Barton. A holding foul on Chris. That is his second. Team fouls. Niagara four. Iona just one. It was flipped the other way at halftime. Iona had 9 team fouls to just 7 for the Purple Eagles. New play call for the Iona Gales. Tim Kluge signals the play. He sends Asante Gist into the deep right corner. Pass to Nikolic. Nikolic to Ricky McGill. Purple Eagles sideline calling out the play. Prochet doing a good job fronting the post player. Now Asante Gist has it. Gist around Hammond. Up and under move. Layup no good. Rebound. Greg King again. Outlet to Barton. Here comes Chris Barton into the front court. 1-0 takes on another. Pass to King. King on the baseline. Spins. Floater. Good! Greg King with a left hand drops it over the rim. Niagara pushes the lead back up to 7. 64-57. 5 in a row for the Purple Eagles. Dominic Fragala at the scorer's table for Niagara. He'll check in at the next whistle. 11:15 left, second half from the Gallagher Center. My name is Todd Callen. Happy to have you along on this Friday night from Montego Ridge. E.J. Crawford, a three from the top. No good. He left it short. Rebound, Greg King. He'll outlet to Hammond. Niagara looking to extend the lead. Marcus Hammond will now dribble things back out. Boy, this young freshman, very composed. Hammond, back pass to Marv. His three on the way. Good! Marvin Prochet hits another triple, and the lead is 10. E.J. Crawford just looked up to the ceiling as if to say, what do I have to do? McGill with it. Now to A.G. A.G. rips it away. Now it's knocked off his hip and out of bounds. It'll be Purple Eagle basketball when we come back. 10:29 left. Timeout. Niagara's on a run. They lead it by 10. From Van Wagner, this is the Purple Eagles Basketball Radio Network. And Greg King went to work. Prochet has four second-half threes, give him 18 points for the game. And Niagara with the possession. A little bit of full-court pressure now as Gist picks up Hammond in the backcourt. Hammond, jump pass now to Prochet over the timeline. Marcus Hammond will dribble it to Raheem Solomon. Solomon, Hammond, Prochet, King, and Dominic Fragala. Man-to-man defense now by the Gales. There's Greg King with it. Double team comes, whips it to Hammond. Marcus Hammond, jump pass to Fragala. Go all the way to the bucket, runner off, glass is good, and a blocking foul, so you can count the bucket by Dominic Fragala. He has five in the lead up to a dozen. He'll go to the line. The foul is on Tawan A.G., that is his second. And A.G. just kind of looking over at Ron Taberski. Tim Kloos a little bit more volume with his disagreement. A.G. gave him a little bit of a wry smile. Kloos is yelling across the floor. Free throw good by Fragala, and the lead now up to 13. Largest lead of the ball game for the Purple Eagles. There's Ricky McGill. Whip pass in the paint. A.G. goes up and slams it through. Again, the no-look pass from McGill to A.G. 70-59, and that rim is really rocking to our right. Hammond with it. Pass Gist into the front court. Floater on the way. Good by Marcus Hammond. They didn't stop the basketball. And Hammond put the basketball in the hoop. 72-59. McGill trying to shake free of Hammond. Takes him down low. Shot on the way is good, and the foul. Ricky McGill just a little bit too powerful there. The senior out-muscling Marcus Hammond along the paint. The basket counts, and McGill will go to the line. First trip to the stripe for the senior from Spring Valley, New York. Sixth in the conference at 77%. McGill opened up conference play with a bang as he knocks in the free throw. How about a season-high 29 against Monmouth? Backcourt pressure. Niagara releases the pass to Raheem Solomon. Now to Hammond. Marcus Hammond, crossover dribble. Now to Fragala on the front court. Dom's going to hoist a three. In and out, no good. Offensive rebound, Greg King with McGill on him. Layup, good! Well, Niagara broke the pressure. They had numbers, and Greg King able to clean up after the miss by Fragala. There's a whistle, and an offensive foul on Ricky McGill will be his fourth. Well, head coach Tim Kloos was rolling the dice, leaving McGill out there with the three fouls. That time, Hammond beat him to the spot. So for McGill, that is his fourth. He is going to stay out on the floor, and you better believe Niagara's going to try and isolate Ricky McGill defensively. Here's Fragala with the basketball with McGill out to get him. And you know Dom's got a lot of wiggle and shake to his game. Hammond with it now, nearly stolen away by Gist. 15 to shoot. Hammond, crossover dribble, jump pass. Fragala, two-pointer on the way. That one is good. Dominic Fragala now with 8 points in the ballgame and a timeout by Iona. To open the season, they had three games and five nights. Timeout over. McGill still out on the floor. We mentioned Iona does not have a deep bench. Who can they go to? We're going to see how long Ricky can stay out there with the four fouls. Pass to E.J. Crawford. Here's Crawford. Double team comes. Picks up his dribble. A.G. traveled. A three on the way. No good. Up and over the backboard it goes. So an empty trip for the Gales, and back come the Purple Eagles. 8:30 left. Niagara just needs to keep going here. Fragala picked up by McGill. Dominic Fragala, 8:23 left. Here's Dom. Bounce pass to King on the baseline. He's 15 feet from the bucket. Now we'll take it to the paint. Spins away and slams it through. A.G. flopped to the floor trying to get the charge. Greg said thank you very much and a two-hand finish. 78-62. Giss now to Crawford. Crawford, jab step on Prochet. Takes him to the paint. Spins. Floater on the way is good and the foul. I think this one's going to go on Marv. He's the one wearing the look of disbelief. Count the bucket, the foul on Marv. That is his first. Timeout, free throw when we come back. Niagara, 78. Iona, 64. More to come after this from Van Wagner. This is the Purple Eagles. 18 to Iona, just 6. Purple Eagles, 13 offensive rebounds. That was at the last media, or at the last timeout. Now we'll get the updated numbers with 7:59 left. 20 second chance points on 14 offensive rebounds for the Purple Eagles. E.J. Crawford for the old-fashioned three-point play, and he swishes in the free throw. A dozen points for the junior from Hartford. 78-65. No pressure off that made free throw, so Hammond will walk it into the front court. Zone defense, 2-3 zone for the Gales. Marcus Hammond, free throw line jumper on the way, no good. Gets his own rebound, and then he's fouled by Perez. It looked worse than it was. Ben Perez banged into Marcus Hammond, and Hammond went down, but that was nothing egregious there. They may take a look at it, but I don't even think there's a knee. The foul on Perez is his first, fourth team foul. Substitution for Niagara. Greg Quacamenza is going to come in, and Marvin Prochet is going to get a rest. Khalif Tate takes off his warm-up. Tate's going to come in. Who's going to check out for Niagara? Dominic Fragala will come out. He is going to sit right next to Coach Casey, and Coach doing a little bit of that, coaching him up. We'll see Fragala again. Quacamenza inbound to King. Fresh shot clock for Niagara. They do not need to hurry. Looping pass caught by Tate with Perez all over him. Now Niagara can balance the floor. Hammond, Quacamenza, Tate, Solomon, and King. Aren't many players out here that have attempted a shot recently. Just Marcus Hammond. Now to Tate. 12 seconds left on the shot clock. Tate goes baseline, slams on the brakes. Now to Quacamenza up top. Hammond's going to hoist a three. High off the rim it goes. No good. Rebound, A.G. A.G. with it now in the front court. 7:15 left to Crawford. E.J. Crawford in the paint. Shot on the way is good. What a finish. E.J. Crawford now with 14. He's going to try and will Iona back into this one. The lead cut to 11, 78-67. See how long the Purple Eagles go without Marvin Prochet. Solomon with it. Raheem off a screen between the legs. Now to Quacamenza. Quacamenza feeds King in the paint. Kicks it out to Leaf. He's going to step into a three. In and out, no good. Oh, is the tide turning here a little bit? Perez in the front court. Now to Crawford. Jump pass back to Perez. His three is airborne, and that is good by Ben Perez. He has 8. Iona has scored 8 of the game's last 10 points, and it's an 8-point lead for Niagara at 78-70. You are never comfortable against these Gales. They can score in bunches. Khalif Tate with it now. Chest pass across the floor, Hammond. Marcus Hammond with it. Who's going to want the shot? Now to Quacamenza. Throw it on the baseline to King. Greg King, jump stop in the paint. Back to Hammond. Extra pass, Leaf. In the corner, Quacamenza's three. Good! Greg Quacamenza from the right corner buries the triple. A reach-in foul on Niagara. I think that's going to be on Hammond. And with 5:56 left, it's the seventh team foul on Niagara, so Iona will shoot free throws. As mentioned at the top, the Gales an awfully good free throw shooting team. That's as a group third in the conference, 72%. And one of the best is Ricky McGill. Ricky 1-for-1 today. He came in number 6 in the MAC. This is a 1-and-1. That three-pointer by Quacamenza put a star by that one. 81-70 the score. Ricky's 1-and-1, and it is good. Slithered over the front rim and stayed down. 18 points for the preseason first-team All-MAC selection. Takes a deep breath. He's out there, got to go as long as he can with those four fouls. Next free throw, that one is good. Got a generous roll and perfect rotation.
81-72, a three-possession game. We're inside of 6 minutes. Niagara's lost three in a row and trying to take down Iona, the three-time defending MAC champions. Here's Raheem Solomon off a screen. His three, tapped up and in by Greg King. King able to finish. He's got 10. 83-72 the score. Niagara up by 11. McGill with it into the front court. Back pass still. He's going to hoist a three. That one no good. He left it short. Rebound. Hammond saves it to Quacamensa. Quacamensa trying to work around the double team, and he is fouled. 5:21 left. And they're going to call it on Isaiah Still, which means Ricky McGill is still in the game. He was in the neighborhood there. Inbounds play to Hammond. Tim Clue still barking at any official that runs by him, saying that Greg King should have been called for offensive goaltending. That's what Coach Clue on the Iona sideline said. Raheem Solomon with it. Raheem had it knocked away. Ball loose near midcourt. Picked up by Still. His pass to Perez. It looked like Still had traveled, but he remains still. Now he flips the pass to Ricky McGill. Here's McGill through the double team. Shot swatted away by Greg King. Good weak side help there by Greg to Hammond. In the front court, Quacamensa. His pass knocked away by Crawford and stolen by A.G. Tuan A.G. in the front court. Picks up the dribble now to Still. Marvin Prochet up off the bench. He'll check in. Now Crawford with it. E.J. Crawford. Wait for A.G. to set the screen. Shot clock at 15. Picks up his dribble. Now a deep three is airborne. Swish! Maybe he knew what he was doing all along. 17 points in the game. Check it now, 19 in the game for E.J. Crawford, and he keeps Iona within shouting distance. 83-75, the Purple Eagles lead it. Tate to Solomon, right back to Khalif Tate. Here's Tate, pass to the defender, jump stop in the paint. Ball fake, leaves it for Raheem. Raheem shot, that one blocked away. A.G.'s got it, nearly stolen from behind, but Iona will bring it away. A.G. to Still, here's Isaiah Still. Crosses over on Tate. His shot, that one no good with Greg King in the neighborhood. Here's Marcus Hammond with it. Now to Solomon. Niagara with numbers. Alley-oop. Slam dunk by Quacamensa. Quacamensa gives Niagara the 10-point lead on a great feed from Solomon. Here's McGill along the baseline. Shot off the window, no good. Rebound loose. Iona's got it. Put back. No, with a foul on Greg Quacamensa with 3:34 left. Free throws upcoming on the other side of this break. Can Niagara get this one to the finish line? They lead it 85-75, 3:34 left. From Van Wagner, this is the Purple Eagles Basketball Radio Network. Out, Marvin Prochet in. Greg King has come out. Dominic Robb back in. Free throw by Still. No good. Too strong. It clanked out. Isaiah Still now just 1-for-5 from the line. He came in at 62%, and that percentage has dropped. He will have another as he tries to split the double team. Marvin Prochet and E.J. Crawford having an extended conversation on the left side of the lane. Free throw good. Two good-natured individuals there, Prochet and Crawford. Still's going to come out. Asante Gist back in. Full court pressure by the Gales. Inbounds play to Hammond. Hammond has gone just about the whole way here in this second half. James Towns still on the sideline. He's healthy, but Hammond has been awfully good. Perez out to get him. Hammond released the pass to Prochet. 3:20 left to Tate, now to Solomon. 13 to shoot. Raheem Solomon goes left wing, flips it to Hammond. Shot clock at 8. Niagara has a three-possession lead, 85-76. Now to Prochet, looks at the shot clock. He'll step back, a 2 on the way. That one no good. And the rebound to A.G. just before it went back in the breadbasket of Marv. E.J. Crawford with it. In the corner to Gist. Gist up top, Perez. Thought about a 3. Good job by Solomon to close quickly on him. Now Gist has got it again around the screen. Now to McGill, a 3 from the corner. That one is good. And Ricky McGill brings Iona to within 6. 85-79. There's Marcus Hammond with it. The freshman playing some pressure minutes here. And a timeout called by Marcus Hammond. The ball rolls right in front of us. And with 2:38 left in the separation, they have given millions back to our member municipalities, including Niagara County. Well, Marcus Hammond stays in. James Towns does check in. But for the Purple Eagles, Khalif Tate goes out. Inbounds play nearly kicked into the backcourt by Towns. 19 on the shot clock, 2:33 left in the game clock. Purple Eagles lead it by 6. Need some points here on this trip.
Towns, throw it on the baseline to Dominic Robb. Backing down Crawford. Floater rimmed out. Tapped up and in by Prochet on the weak side. What a second half by Marv Prochet. That's a huge bucket. Niagara back up by eight. Giss now to Agee. Fakes a three. Pass Dominic Robb. Shot in the way, no good. But a foul by Dom will send Agee to the line to shoot two. That is the third on Dominic Robb. Each team surpassing or just about ready to surpass their per-game average. Iona averages 79. Niagara has long blown past their 71-point average. Agee trying to get Iona their 80th point. He is 2-for-2 from the line today. Free throw on the way is good. Tawan Agee from the Windy City. Another new player brought in by Tim Cluis here in his junior season. 87-80 our score. The crowd will go quiet as Tawan Agee has to tuck in his jersey. Very peaceful move. Now we're ready to go. Trying to make it a 6-point Niagara lead. Free throw is good. He swishes that one in. 20 points for Agee. Prochet inbound to Hammond. Right back to Prochet. Marv with it now. Good job handling the basketball. Over the stripe now to Towns. James Towns can take it under 2 minutes, and he does. Niagara by six. 1:55 left. Shot clock at 16. Prochet with the catch. He'll flip it to Marcus Hammond. He'll give it to Raheem Solomon. Two freshmen and three upperclassmen on the floor. Here's Towns to the bucket. Shot in the way. No good. Followed by Solomon, and it's good. Raheem Solomon, his first field goal here in the second half. Agee to the bucket. Layup. Yes. Tawan Agee finishes in the blink of an eye at the other end. Marcus Hammond with it now. Outlet pass to Prochet. He'll take it over the stripe. 1:25 left. Niagara's lead is six. Solomon to Hammond. Just five team fouls for the Gaels. Hammond with it. Now to James Towns. Towns bounce pass Prochet. Shot clock at eight. Here's Hammond on the catch. Game clock at 1:10. Bounce pass. Robb, a 16-footer. Swish! Dominic Robb from the baseline. He's got 13. Niagara's lead is 8. 1 minute left. Niagara, 1 minute away from perhaps their first conference win. E.J. Crawford layup is good, and the foul. Crawford ends up on the baseline. The foul on Dominic Robb is his fourth, and hold on. Well, E.J. Crawford yet to get up, folks, and for the Iona fans that are listening and watching the game, E.J. was grabbing at his back, but maybe just wanted two teammates to help him up. Ricky McGill and Ben Perez do the honors, and E.J. trying to flex out that back a little bit, now puts two hands on his back. 91-85 the score. Niagara's lead is 6, 54.5 seconds left. Now they're going to dry off the basketball. Bill McCarthy will do that. Each team with one timeout left. 54.5 seconds left. You can bet there will be full court pressure off a made free throw. Iona still one foul to give, and that may not be playing in their favor. Crawford at the line. He's 1-for-1. Free throw on the way is no good. Long rebound. Marcus Hammond rips it away, and the foul by Iona. They got a hook and hold call on Ben Perez. That is his second. Well, I guess just a holding foul, not the hook and hold. So the foul on Perez is his second, team sixth foul. And on the replay, Tawan Agee went down. He was not involved in the foul at all. He's fine. Marvin Prochet to inbound. Ron Taberski reminds him that he cannot move. 53.3 seconds left. Niagara trying to win this. They lead it by six, 91-85. Prochet to inbound. He needs to hurry. Finds James Towns, but gets knocked out of bounds. Last touch by the Gaels. So now Niagara will inbound on the other side of the bucket. No time came off the clock. That's interesting. So they're going to look. Are they going to have to take some time off the clock? You would think that they would have to take some time off the clock.
because if nobody touched it, it's Iona ball, but someone did, and now they, I believe they're going to take a look at this. 53 seconds exactly. By rule, we get the information from Bill McCarthy that by rule, 0.3 seconds must come off. That's a good rule. Crochet is going to throw it the length of the floor. James Townsend gets there, and Asante Gist steals it. 50 seconds left. In the corner, A.G. whips it across the court. That one knocked away by Marcus Hammond. Oh, that one was headed for us. 44.8 seconds left. Iona ball. Niagara leading it by 6. We were ready here. Got to protect the equipment. LCTV monitor was almost in play. 91-85. One more stop by the Purple Eagles. 44.8 seconds left. They start the clock. Ricky McGill's got it now to Crawford. Those two are the scoring options you would think. Perez now to Gist. Asante Gist back to Perez. Didn't hoist the three. Gist has it. Free throw line. Pass. Crawford layup. Yes. E.J. Crawford knocks it in. Final timeout called by Iona. It stays a 2. Passionate care. Modern technology. Exceptional results. Crochet to inbound. He can run the baseline if he wants. He does so. Inbounds play to James Towns. Towns with the double team coming. Tied up. What do we have? A jump ball. The arrow favors Iona. The Purple Eagles turn it over. The pass in the corner. Towns was unable to release his pass. And with 25.7 seconds left, it'll be Iona basketball. 91-87 the score. Purple Eagles leading it by 4. This is starting to resemble the game for Niagara at Pitt, where Niagara wobbled a little bit at the end. Inbounds play to McGill. Jumper on the way. No good. He left it short. Marcus Hammond, the rebound. He'll dribble away from trouble. And the reach-in foul by E.J. Crawford. 21.2 seconds left. The foul on E.J. is his third. So Marcus Hammond, the freshman for Niagara, will go to the line to shoot the 1-1. The biggest 1-1 of his collegiate career. 91-87. Niagara with the lead. Hammond on the season is 8-for-10, 80%. The freshman hears Bill McCarthy bark out that it's a 1-1. He knew it. Hammond's first free throw. Good. He swishes that one in. 3 points for Marcus Hammond. Up off the bench for the Purple Eagles, Chris Barton. Barton is going to check in for the shooter, so Hammond will have another, trying to give Niagara the 6-point lead. The building gets quiet. Swish! 4 points for Marcus Hammond. Chris Barton's going to come in, and actually Raheem Solomon will come out. So Solomon out, Barton in. Niagara leads it by 6. One more miss and a rebound, and it should do it for the Purple Eagles. Here's Gist. He's going to fire a 3. It's on the way, and it's good! Asante Gist makes it a 3-point game. 93-90. Inbound play to Towns, and he gets bodied off the court by E.J. Crawford. That's his fourth. And now James Towns will go to the line for the Purple Eagles. Eighth team foul, so another 1-1 for the Purple Eagles. Boy, James Towns has been great in the late going. Number one from the free throw line in the conference. He will have the 1-in bonus. First time to the line tonight. Free throw. No good. Too strong. It rimmed out. Rebound Iona. Here comes A.G. 12 seconds left. He'll give it to Gist. Niagara leads it by 3. 8 seconds left. Gist with it. He's going to rise up. A high arcing 3. Partially deflected by Dominic Robb. It'll be Niagara basketball with 2.2 seconds left. The long arm of the leading shot blocker in the MAC, Dominic Robb, affected that shot. Raheem Solomon back in. Chris Barton will go out. And they're going to look at this one again. 2.2 seconds left. They will send both clubs to their bench. In this very spot at Pittsburgh, Niagara turned the ball over. They survived and won the game. They've got to be clean here. Crochet the inbound to Hammond, and he is fouled by Ricky McGill with 1.1 second left. And for McGill, that is his fifth. He had to do it. So Ricky McGill will foul out with 22 points. 1.1 second left. The ninth team foul. Marcus Hammond can drive the final nail in this one.
Bill McCarthy will call Sean Campbell over. They just want to talk things over. Marvin Prochet is along the free throw line. That is so he can contest some backcourt, a little bit of backcourt pressure. Or will they ask Prochet to foul if Hammond misses this? If Marcus Hammond makes this, everything else is for naught. This is to put it away. It's good! The Purple Eagles are going to win this one. What a night for Niagara. 94-90, they lead it. Marcus Hammond, another one, 95-90. Inbounds play. Gist fires it from midcourt. There goes the horn, and this one is over.